In the late 1800s, governments had invested over $1 billion in aviation projects by reputed scientists. However, the results were disastrous. In 1896, American inventor Samuel Langley received a grant from the US War Department to develop a piloted airplane. He failed after two crashes on takeoff. In 1897, French inventor Clément Ader received funding from the French War Department to fly his steam-powered aircraft, Avion III. He failed when the plane lost control. In 1896, leading aviation expert Otto Lilienthal died after his glider lost control and crashed. He was the first person to make successful flights using gliders and recorded his experiments in his journal. When even the most prominent scientific minds had tried and failed, how did the Wright brothers pioneer aviation? The Wright brothers were no scientists. They were entrepreneurs with a passion for aviation ever since their father brought home a helicopter-like toy. The death of Lilienthal, an aviator who the brothers greatly admired, reignited their desire to conquer the skies. In 1899, the brother began investigating years of research data from reputed scientists and aviators. As successful entrepreneurs selling custom-made bicycles, they realized that flying, like bike riding, can only be done if you can control the flight. An insight that eluded other flight enthusiasts. They considered their flying machine to be a system that required solutions for three main issues: lift, to overcome gravity; propulsion, to move forward; and to control, which is to steer the airplane. The solutions for the first two were well established: wings and engines, respectfully, and only needed some tweaking. No one had cracked the secret to controlled flight. To figure out how to control a flying machine, the Wright brothers observed large birds taking off and maintaining their balance against the wind. They discovered that when large birds fly, they raise the tip of one wing while lowering the top of the other to steer themselves. Using this insight, they invented wing warping, the concept of twisting the wing structure. Warped wings allowed pilots to turn their gliders while maintaining balance. Having put all the pieces together in 1901, they ran their tests using unmanned gliders at the remote sandy beach of Kitty Hawk, North Carolina. After a few trials, Wilbur Wright decided to try piloting it himself. No one got hurt, but the trial failed miserably. The gliders produced a lift that was just one-third of what the brothers' calculations predicted. Even after experimenting with the dimensions, the gliders wouldn't lift, leaving the Wright brothers baffled. That's when they decided to recheck their data. Just like every other aviator, the Wright brothers had used the scientifically proven equation for lift and drag to design their gliders. Values such as the wing surface area and wind speed were easy to measure. The brothers were confident that these weren't causing the problem. However, the lift factor and Smeaton's coefficient, which is the pressure factor, were all derived from the work of others. The brothers focused on these areas to determine the reason for their failure. To measure these values, the brothers created a simple wind tunnel from scratch and started studying the effect of airflow on metal. Since the 18th century, engineers had been using Smeaton's coefficient to calculate the density of air. After running over 50 simulations using their wind tunnels, the brothers determined the true value to be 0.0033 and not 0.005. 18 months later, on December 17, 1903, at Killdevil Hills near Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, man's first powered, controlled, and sustained flight came to life. At first, Orville Wright flew the Wright Flyer for 12 seconds, covering 120 feet at 6.8 miles per hour, making it the first controlled flight. After a few more trials, Wilbur Wright flew the Wright Flyer, traveling 852 feet in 59 seconds, successfully piloting a heavier-than-air machine completely under his control. The Wright brothers conquered the skies, not just because they were enterprising and dedicated. They did several things differently, from doing their own research, to building wind tunnels to validate their data and eliminate guesswork.